Good morning. Welcome to our St. Charles City Purple Heart Ceremony. St. Charles has the honor of having been designated a Purple Heart City. And as such, we have the duty to host Purple Heart Day. And today, the 7th of August, is Purple Heart Day. And that is there to honor Purple Heart recipients while reminding our citizens of sacrifices and valor in combat of those who have borne the burden of battle. Congress authorized the Purple Heart flag to be flown over designated cities like ours on this day. This morning we have with us Vietnam veteran who will be raising the flag, and the award itself was the nation's oldest medal for combat heroism, awarded only to those who were wounded or posthumously to those killed in combat action. It was designed and first awarded by General George Washington. So with that in mind, we will begin our ceremony. And I would ask you to please stand, if you are able, for a prayer given by Larry Brown, who is the chaplain of VFW Post 866. And Larry is a Purple Heart recipient himself and has also been awarded two Distinguished Flying Crosses. Chaplain, please remove your...
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, on this day, the first anniversary of our designation as a Purple Heart City, help us to be ever mindful of the significance of this occasion. We ask your blessing on all who have earned this medal and the significance of this award. We ask for your strength and courage to Purple Heart families whose loved ones have incurred serious, often debilitating injuries, which inflict everlasting burdens on their lives. Grant peace and comfort to the families of those who gave the ultimate sacrifice. Their pain will never be completely healed. Let's now observe a few moments of silence for those brave departed soldiers and their families and loved ones who yet today grieve their loss. These things we ask in thy holy name. Amen. Amen. Recover.
Please remain standing as we have our call to colors for our trumpeter and also a city council member, Michael Vandermeyer. Flag detail, Tench Hut, present harm. Please be seated. A probably had them seat too soon here, Don Newman, because you have a Pledge of Allegiance here. So Don Newman will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag.
Y'all rise again, please. Join me, present arms. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Two.
Thank you. Okay, now you can sit down. Oh, my goodness. We're fortunate here in the city of St. Charles to have a mayor who indeed is a combat veteran from Vietnam, and we certainly want to welcome him this morning to say a few words, Mayor Dan Borgmeyer. He, by the way, is a red leg. That's an artilleryman. So there you go.
Thank you, Tom. Morning, everybody. Thank you for being here. I want to compliment Councilman Flandemeyer on his performance. The only two times I like to hear that was I hated Reveille, but I loved the end of the day with Taps. So welcome to Purple Heart Recognition Day program here at City Hall. On behalf of the City of St. Charles, I want to thank St. Charles City Veterans Commission, particularly Chairman Tom Kuipers, who's made today possible, and for letting me be a part of it. This is now the second year we've gathered here for this occasion, and it's an honor to recognize those that have earned the prestigious Purple Heart. The Purple Heart Medal is awarded to members of the armed forces of the U.S. who are wounded by an instrument of war in the hands of the enemy, or to the next of kin in the name of those who are killed in action or die of wounds received in action. It is specifically a combat decoration. We are thrilled that the City of St. Charles is now recognized as a Purple Heart City. We have signs throughout the city letting everyone know this designation, as well as 5 designated parking spaces at city facilities for Purple Heart recipients. And the Purple Heart flag being raised today is just another wonderful symbol of this designation to honor those that have served our country. Thanks to you, to all the military that are here today, and those that could not be with us. And I'm going to reiterate a little bit something I talked about last year, and that is people look at Purple Hearts and they look at all the other awards and ribbons and things that you're given as a result of your service, and they're nice. It's like the trophy you get for winning a golf tournament or the trophy you get for winning some other award. But the fact of the matter is the Purple Heart has a very, very strong connection to the service for the country. I'm sure you've all seen the thing that when you sign up for the military, you basically write the country a blank check for your life. I think the Purple Heart falls just short of those who gave the ultimate sacrifice. And like I said last year, you don't get it if you didn't get hurt. And even though it's an incredible award, you carry those scars and those whatever for the rest of your life. Those guys that are lucky enough to receive the Purple Heart and survive will carry that thought with them the rest of their lives. And that, to me, is the second most ultimate service to your country. I'm very proud of those people. I'm proud that we're a Purple Heart city. I'm very pleased to be associated with it from that respect. I was a red leg, or whatever Tom called me. I know that Don Stolberg is a jarhead. And and I know many of you others served in, actually my military unit was an artillery unit, but we were attached to the Big Red One. So we actually traveled with an infantry company, and they used us like tanks. So it was an interesting experience. I've also said that the reason that 19, 20-year-old kids are in the Army is because when you're 20 or 19 and they say charge that hill, you charge. And when you're 40 years old and they say charge that hill, you say, let's talk about this hill. Okay. We didn't have that advantage when most of us were there, and as a result, we did what we were supposed to do. Some of them took the heat and got the Purple Heart, and some of the other of us were lucky enough to come out unscathed. So to all of our brothers that got it, congratulations, God bless you, and thank you for the ceremony today.
Thank you, Mayor. Art Miner from the Korean War Veterans Association Chapter 6 has a Purple Heart prologue. Art?
Thank you, Tom. This year, I'd like to talk a little bit about an organization called Purple Heart Reunited. On July 23rd, 2012, Purple Heart United was formed, located in St. Albans, Vermont. Their mission is to return lost or stolen medals of valor to the veterans or the veterans' families who earned them. They receive about 3 to 5 medals a month that needs to be identified and returned. One example of their work, last February, they hosted a night of patriotism in Lakewood, Florida, to return medals to families of 2 veterans, one from World War I and one from World War II. The World War I veteran was an Army private who was killed in action on October 7, 1918, in France, where he was buried. Then later, in 1921, his family brought him back to his home state, Ohio. He never received the Purple Heart. The World War II veteran was an Army Air Corps lieutenant who was killed on March 28, 1945, and buried in Holland. His Purple Heart was lost by somehow. Both families were in attendance to receive their veterans' Purple Hearts. Very nice organization. Thank you.
Thank you, Art. And of course, the reason we have this day is to honor our recipients. So anyone out there in the audience who has been a recipient of the Purple Heart Medal, please stand. And I know we do have one at least here. Our chaplain of VFW Post 2866. So give Chaplain Brown a hand there. Special thanks also to St. Charles City Public Works who put this together and kind of organized it. And we thank you for attending. And this officially ends the ceremony. And the flag will fly all day. Thank you very much.